साल बड़े हैं।
हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज द फर्स्ट वीडियो फॉर क्लास 9, द सब्जेक्ट इंफॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी एंड कोड फॉर दिस सब्जेक्ट इज 402। ओके, नाउ टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टेल यू इन दिस वीडियो दैट व्हाट यू हैव टू लर्न इन दिस सब्जेक्ट इंफॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी। यू हैव टू लर्न 5 यूनिट्स इन दिस सब्जेक्ट। सो यूनिट 1, what is having in unit 1? Unit 1 will include communication technology. Unit 2, self-management skills. Self-skills. Unit 3 is information and communication technology skills. Information and communication technology skills. In unit 4, entrepreneurial skills. In 5th unit, green skills. Now, among this 5 units, today I am going to tell you communication technology, the first chapter from the communication technology, or you can say the first topic from the communication technology skills. And after that, I'll shift to information and communication technology skills. In the first unit, you will come to know that what the informations are, why it is required to convey it, what is having in communication technology, and in third unit, the same informations, how conveyed through the technologies, so that it is information and communication technology, right? So let us start the first unit, communication technology. So today I'm going to tell you what is communication. This is very important to know what is communication. Okay, communication, you can say that it is the process of transferring process of transferring or sharing information, okay, between two or more people. Information between two or more people, right? So to whom this information is shared? Let us start again this definition. Communication is the process of transferring or sharing, okay, transferring or sharing information. So what is being transferred? Information, okay. Among whom this is going to be transferred? Between the people, okay. So how many people are get involved there? There can be either two people or there can be more than two people, okay? There can be two people or there can be more than two people. So any number of people can be there. So in the transferring of information, clear everyone? And if you will start thinking, okay, So you will come to know that how this communication is important for our life. Okay? If you will take the example that this video is one of the example for the transfer of information. This is the means through which the information is transferred from one to many. Right? When we are doing verbal communication, right? There can also be, that can be the face-to-face communication. Right, and nowadays you are very well familiar that not only the face-to-face communication we have telephonic conversations, communications, right? We are having nowadays the conferencing, audio conferencing, video conferencing. So we have many ways we are nowadays through which we are communicating with the people, right now? So now, here you have to, it is very important that for the proper information, we need to follow some proper rules among the people, right? We need to follow the proper rules or the proper protocols among the people. If that rule will not be followed, that communication will be, that information will be spoiled, that proper information will not be conveyed, and that communication will be stop there only. Clear? So what are the very important things in this communication that we will talk about, the life cycle of this communication cycle? Okay, so communication is the foundation of all human relationships. We communicate every day with our family, teachers, friends, and any sources, okay, in our surrounding. The need for communication is what? Why it is needed to communicate the information? Okay, if you will see the earliest people, human beings, okay, so in early years also there was a sign language, right? People were, when they were not, there was no language, so at that time people were communicating using the sign languages, okay. And after that, again the verbal communication and the written messages. Clear na? So how many ways the communication was possible? Through the written or the verbal communication. In this way, what kind of communication can be there? The communication can be verbal communication, and there can be the written communication. Okay? So in verbal communication, there can be the sources involved, face to face or through the telephones. And the in written communication, there requires some medium through which the message is transferred. Okay? Now, there is having, communication is a two-way process. It cannot be one way. Clear? It cannot be one way. It cannot be that one person is sending the information, right, to the other person, and when the other person will not reply, okay, when the other person will not reply, right, so what will happen, the first person will not be able to communicate with the other person, right? So when a message sent by the one person, right, they want the reverse, in reverse they want a feedback from the other person. Right? Feedback from the other person. That feedback can be anything, the reply of the message or any form or the any kind of, any way it can be the received by the sender. Now, let us see that what are the effective communication rules are there. Okay? How the people will be able to effectively communicate. Okay? Communication is a meaningful process and involves a sender and receiver. Two person it requires. What they requires? They requires sender and they requires receivers. Who receive the messages which was sent by the sender. Clear na? So, there is the receiver. Clear? Sender is sending the message and receiver is receiving the message. Clear everyone? And while communication, both should share the mutual acceptance. Okay? It should be when one person will speak, other will hear. when the other person will speak, the first person will listen, right? Now, so this mutual understanding must be there in between two people. So the first point is what? They must have the mutual understanding. Clear? While communicating, while the communication from the sender to receiver, when the sender is sending the message, the receiver must listen to it, and when receiver will send the information, the sender the first person must listen to it. So this is called the mutual understanding between two people. Okay, and they must speak common language. There must be mutual understanding. Okay, there must be mutual understanding. Right? Now, next one is what? You can say that there is a feature of effective communication. Effective communication feature. Okay, effective communication feature. First, mutual understanding. Both must speak the common language. Common language. Both must speak the common language. Okay, now a message should be very clear. It should be conveyed the right meaning to the other person. Message should be very clear. Okay, clear message should be there. Okay, and the meaning of the message should be very clear. Okay, message should be very clear, and the meaning should also be understood by the another person. Okay, now another part is there. The listening to other is a very important aspect of effective communication. Okay, so listening by the other party. Listening to others. These are the points for the very effective communication. Communication is the process in which there is the input and output, which is taught to you from the beginning when you started learning computer. From that time, this input and output is being there, and it is also explained to you that in our daily life also, we require input, we require process, and we require output, and then we are getting the output. Okay, now come to the another one point also. Write down response from the receiver. Okay, response from the receiver. This is the points for the effective communication. Okay, now let us see what is the impact of this effective communication in our day-to-day life. Okay, obviously the proper information will not be conveyed. Okay, if proper information will not be conveyed, right, and the proper way, it cannot be listened or interpreted by the other party, the information will be useless. Clear now? So you can see that what is the impact of effective communication on our lives. Okay, impact of effective communication in our on our lives. Okay, impact of effective communication on our life. Okay.